just about every area. And so, you know, they kind of put you in a position where how much of a team you are, you know, is kind of put to the test. And so it would be a good opportunity for us to see where we are today.
Is this one of those games where the mental toughness is just as important as the physical toughness?
Yeah, I mean, it always is. You know, it's really where, you know, the performance kind of lies is in the mental part of it. And so, you know, like I was just saying, that's what really good teams do to you. You know, they test you mentally more than physically. And so, you know, we'll see how it starts out tonight and then play the game accordingly.
Derek, I know you obviously spent a lot of time playing with Luke Wall. Steve just came back a couple weeks ago. What do you think about his personality allowed him to kind of keep this machine rolling while Steve was doing that?
No, I think that, you know, Luke has an overall understanding of the game. You know, he's comfortable in his own skin. You know, he's not really trying to impress anybody. You know, I think that that level of comfort with himself and the confidence that he has in himself, you know, helped him to, you know, step right in and do a great job.
Coach,
played with him. Did you ever see him as a coach material?
No. I've asked you about the play. We thought about playing.
You were obviously with a team that won 67 games.
Yes.
And you played against a team that won 72. What do you see this team playing against tonight? Historically great.
I don't have anything to do with that.
Coach,
we have one game to play tonight. That's all.
Sorry,
you three.
Any tip from the last night, the Warriors versus Sixers?
Yeah, I mean, hopefully some guys watched the game yesterday. No, I think that, you know, it's tough over the course of 82 games to be at your best every night. But they found a way to make more plays than their opponent. It's the NBA. And, you know, every win you get, you take it. You know, that won't have any bearing on how they perform tonight, though. So, you know, we'll have to be ready to play and assume that they'll be at their best tonight.
Derek, if you had the task to check the recovery, how would you go about it?
I don't have that task. So.
But you played and, you know, you faced some pretty potent offensive players. When you look at him, what would you do as an individual?
Yeah, again, it's not about what I would do, it's about what our guys that are playing will need to do. And that's what you have to do against every player, especially the really good ones. Let's make them work extremely hard. You know, some nights, guys are still gonna have numbers, they're still gonna be successful, but you have to make them work and earn everything that they get. You know, kind of embrace the opportunity to play against what is considered to be the best. So, you know, we'll see what we do.
Coach, we've
seen Lance Thomas defend some of the top perimeter guys. Kevin Durant, James Harden, did pretty well against both of them. Are you comfortable with him pushing out on Curry at points?
Yeah, we're comfortable with Lance guarding anybody.
Are you looking to exploit, because the Warriors can sometimes be careless with the ball, and you exploit turnovers, you guys have been able to cause teams to turn the ball over, and you can really exploit that tonight?
I think you have to take advantage of opportune times to run against this team. You know, because of the style that they play, there are going to be a lot of three-point attempts. The ball will bounce long. You'll have chances to get after 50-50 balls and possibly run out. But you also have to be careful not to fall in love with that style of play. You know, to play against a team that averages 115 points per game, you know, they're better suited for that than anybody else. So, you know, if you can force turnovers and get out, great. But I also think you have to have some smarts and some purpose to everything you do offensively as well.
How challenging is this team? Normally, with most teams, you have something, especially if you feel like you have weapons defensively in KP or Robin, that you can take something away. How do you go about trying to take something away from this team without making the wrong identification in terms of who you're leaving in a corner, or what have you, how do you go about trying to decipher what you're comfortable giving up against this team?
No, you just have to make them work and keep competing. And, know that they're going to make shots at times, they're going to score points, you're going to play great defense, they're still going to score. You play great defense, they'll get an offensive rebound, kick it out to somebody, they'll make a three. And you just have to find ways to keep playing the game and not kind of give in to the ups and downs of it. Not try and turn individual situations into, kind of match up things and, just stay away from that and remain as a team and keep working hard. And I think, guys, for us, we have to walk out there expecting to win. I don't know if you guys are going to walk in there and ask them the same questions you're asking me, but I would be offended if I was them.
Coach, with regard, sorry, were you finished?
Yeah.
No, sorry, I didn't want to interrupt. With regards to Thanasis, I know you've said that he plays sort of a limited role if he does get onto the court, but when he actually does play, what do you expect to see from him that might enable him to make the roster full time?
I think a level of competitiveness and grit that a lot of guys don't play with. Not necessarily on our roster, but it's, I think, league wide. Guys just don't play hard every single possession. And that's not an easy thing to do. And I think he plays that way. And I think when you have that, then the skills of how to shoot and experience in terms of reading offenses and defenses, you can learn those things. But sometimes it's hard for guys to learn how to play hard. I think he does that.
I think when the Suns were very successful in regular season, the speed match team, and then they got in the playoffs. The theory was that kind of style of play would not be successful in the playoffs. Them winning a championship last year, the Warriors, did that kind of debunk that theory?
I don't know. I mean, it just depends on who you play. I mean, the team you're talking about played against a team that was better than them not playing them. So, I don't know if it debunks anything other than they won the championship. And I don't know who's going to win the championship this year, but it's just a popular thing to do and to talk about after the team that wins. Everybody then somehow wants to emulate and copy that, still the game of basketball. So, we'll see what happens from that standpoint. But, the shooting is sexy, but they still get 60 points in the paint, and that's kind of what tricks you.
Derek, if there's one thing that you guys need to do tonight to come away with a win, what would that be?
Just keep playing. They're going to make runs. They're going to make shots. And I think they kind of take the air out of your lungs, when they hit you with a 10-2 run, and all of a sudden you try to get it back in one possession, you start to shoot quick shots because they're shooting quick shots. So I think we'll just have to find ways to continue to play no matter how the game is being played. And I think there has to be a brand of physicality and toughness that the game has to be played with in order to be the team.
From your unique experience having guarded Curry through the years in his younger days, and are you able to share that with the team, just with your guards? And are you able to talk to them about just, what it's like to try to stop him?
Not specifically in terms of defending him. I think he's a different player than he was even last year. So, it's tough to compare what he was doing 5 or 6 years ago even. But in terms of sharing my experience or thoughts about how to defend in general against certain players or a certain style of play offensively, I try to offer that to guys. But, basketball is also a game of instincts. And if you're too clouded, crowded with thoughts about how to do something, you kind of get locked up and don't just do it. So, we have some guys that are pretty solid defensively, and we kind of have to trust their instincts even though he's a unique player.
Do you have to essentially pick him up right at half court with where he's been shooting from, like you said, last year to this year? It seems like he's been comfortable pulling up from a lot further out than he was last year.
Yeah, no, I just think you got to be willing to not worry about being embarrassed. Guys are so sensitive about being on the highlight. And your job is playing out in front of the world. Don't worry about the highlight. just keep guarding and keep playing. If he makes a three in your face, fine. If he crosses you over, fine. But the next time he comes back, you should still be standing right there.
Yeah, that was Derek. What is your 67 win team? What they're doing? The same thing? Something to be on town, mental toughness, to do that, win that many every night in all that day?
No, it always does. I mean, I don't know if it's a number of wins thing that defines it, but you know, to consistently win in this league at 50 plus, 60%, 70% win percentages, it's all mental. I mean, the physical talent, you know, in this league, you know, across the board is pretty high. And obviously some teams are more talented than others, but you know, the mental challenges are the ones that separate the greatest ones from the greatest teams. And, you know, they seem to have found, you know, whatever that is that works for them to be able to sustain high performance. And, you know, we're not comparing ourselves to them, but one day we're going to be able to sustain performance at a high level as well.
When you say he's a unique talent, have you seen a player like him before?
No, because he's only him. I mean, nobody else. I'm not a guy that tries to compare, you know, a lot of guys with other, you know, other players that have come before them or guys that may come after. So, you know, I don't think we can say we've seen a player like him since him.
Coach, you talked a few times this year about, you know, Porzingis in terms of putting on weight so we can guard bigger guys. When you run into a team like this that goes small, spreads the floor, does it change that a little bit because you still want him to maintain the agility to be able to move around with small lineups if he plays that?
Yeah, I mean, if I recall when we talked about that a little bit, you know, I mentioned, you know, gaining weight still consistent with his strength levels and not necessarily being like an arbitrary number to gain, but that it has to be consistent with functional strength and his movement and, you know, the speed and quickness that he does have in his size. And so, you know, the earliest gains are always the quickest ones, you know, so he to gain the first 10 or 12 pounds as a young man works well, but it, you know, doesn't mean that he needs to gain 12 or 15 or 20 more to be better and more effective. And I think overall he plays a pretty aggressive game, and so I think he'll naturally get bigger and stronger as he matures. But for sure, we want to always try and keep him at a place, and guys overall at a place where they're still functional and can move and do the things they need to do.
All right, thank you.